Hi guys, welcome. Today we're going to take a look at the this week released version of Fedora, Fedora 31. Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. So we're going through the installation, and we'll also be going through what's installed by default on the system. So let's see. It's going through a startup process. Fedora is backed by it sees it as a distribution to test a couple of things. Fedora is very stable. Normally it will just be very good for your system because it is very stable and you can use a lot of it. Is it the most easy one? No, but it is a very nice system. The default one is based on the GNOME desktop. So here you can see the GNOME desktop. We'll continue in English. And there are also a lot of spin-offs, but we'll show that at the end. So let's do that. Let's first go through the installation steps. So as you can see, you select the disk here. So we go in there. The disk is already selected. You can do it automatically, of course. You can do it customly or advanced. You can encrypt your data here. I will now leave it just as default. So we go through the default installation steps. My keyboard's English US, time, date, Europe, Amsterdam, that's fine. Okay, begin the installation. So this can take a while, so I'll pause the video and we'll get back when it's done. So we're back, the installation has been done. So we click on finish installation. And we reboot the machine. So if all goes well, we should be booting now from our hard drive in full screen again, as it did. So we see the startup. So here we are at the welcome screen that comes after it, because we didn't create any users yet and that kind of stuff. So this can be installed as a default installation on a machine, and then afterwards the customer starts the machine and can do his own settings. So location services, if you want them to determine your location services, I don't want that. Automatic problem reporting, I'll leave it on for now, so that's good. Your online accounts, if you want to add them here already, I will skip it. So your full name, your username, and also they have the option here for enterprise login. So if you have LDAP and that kind of stuff, or an Active Directory in your company network, you can use this one. We're using local, so we go next. We put in our password. And we are ready to go. Start. So it refreshes the session. And here we get the getting started screen. So here you can go to the common tasks. So launch your applications. How do you do it? But this is more the GNOME help. Switch task. How do you do it? So, and use the Windows and the workspaces. Change your wallpaper, use Windows and workspaces, but I will show that. So we have the default GNOME. So your sound is up there. Your wired or Wi-Fi network will be up there. Your account, your shutdown restart button, your lock button, and your settings. In the middle, we'll have the calendar. The calendar is nice and blue, very smooth. Okay. And in the left corner, you have the activities. You can access these by clicking on it or by hitting the Windows or Meta key. You get the same screen. So on the left, you have your taskbar. On the right, you have your workspaces. GNOME is based is very handy in workspaces. If you add a workspace, it will add another one, another one, another one. So you have multiple workspaces that you can use. So here you have also show your applications. You click on it, and it will show all the applications that are installed on the system at this moment. You can access these via this way. So if you do it with the activities and then go applications, but the most common way I use in a GNOME environment is you do your Windows key and your A, and it will go automatically to your application screen. If you want to do a normal search, you just hit the Windows key and start typing the name of the program that you want to start. So let's start files. As you can see, Fedora is using the basic theme from the GNOME. So it uses the Adwaita GNOME. But all the other settings are just right there. So your search settings, with your selected dates, with anything, full text, full name. Here you can zoom in, you can use all the other stuff here. You can add tabs, new window, new tab, or new folder. You show your hidden files, your preferences here. So this is files. It's Nautilus, but in GNOME it's called files. So what is installed on the system? We have boxes, that's the virtual front end for your native Linux virtual engine. So like I'm using now from what you saw in the beginning of during the restart, I'm using QEMU with the virtual manager, and boxes is also something that instead of the virtual manager, you can use boxes to have your virtual machines, and you can handle your machines there. So if I start boxes, here you can see, so I can add a new virtual machine, so create a new virtual machine, and here it says create a box, so continue. And here you have a lot of options on what kind of operating system that you do you want to use, or you download an OS or select a file. So if you have an ISO downloaded, you can use it as well. Nice front end, default in GNOME. We have the calendar, we have cheese for your camera, clocks, contacts, document scanner, the files, we just saw that, Firefox. So Firefox, the one that they installed by default is version, let me see, where's my help about Firefox. So 69 is installed by default. I think I'll do an upgrade, it goes to 70, but should be. We have LibreOffice installed by default. LibreOffice version 6.3.2.2, so very good. We have maps. So you can look at all the maps here. So we're in the Netherlands. Location. Zoom in, zoom out. So this is where I live instead of Amsterdam, but yeah, I live here. So very good, very smooth. We have the Photos application, Rhythmbox for your music, your settings, your software center, your text editor is gedit by default in GNOME, so it's gedit. As you can see. We have videos and we have the utilities. Utilities will show all the things that you have by default, so an archive manager, calculator, your character map. Your disk uses your disk handler, so let's see how the disk was built. So they had one partition and the rest is there. So they have one entire partition here. And they use LVM by default. What else? Fonts, image viewer, your logs, your system monitor, your terminal, system monitor. So by default we're having 1.1 gigabyte of memory in use. The CPU is still very nice, although it's now high, but yeah, it's a virtual machine, so yeah, most likely it will be high. And what else is installed? Oh, weather. Yeah, you can use the weather. So let's go to the software center. They use the default GNOME software center. So here you can see the GNOME software center. And here they said, do you want to enable the third party repositories? I would advise you to do that, so enable that one. And here you have your updates. So where it says that it has 9 updates, so it will show the updates here. But if we go back to the Explorer and we do a search, let's go for HTOP. No application found because it's something that needs to be installed extra. But here you can select all your default applications. So let's go to audio video. Well, you have all your GNOME audio and video things. Games, developer tools, graphics and photographics. So you have your GIMP, your Inkscape. So yeah, Software Center. You can use for your updates and your installation of your software, of course. So restart an update is it saying now. I won't be doing that now at this moment. If you go to the terminal, they don't have the default key binding. You go to the terminal and if you want to update or install some software, you use DNF. So Fedora is using DNF as its installer. DNF. Install, let's do GIMP, and it will ask you for your password, of course. And then it will ask you if you agree with what is going to be installed, so all the packages that are needed are being installed, so say yes. And here you can see that it's nicely installing that program. So already done. So let's go to the software again. And GIMP is installed. You can start GIMP. And it is almost, I think, the latest one. Sorry. No, 10.12, so that's 10.10. So it's a bit older one, but it's very good. Stable. So if you right click on your desktop, you can change your background, display settings, or your settings. Change the background. Let's see what backgrounds they have installed by default. So It looks very nice. A couple of nice ones there. This one is very nice. Countryside. This is very nice. Yeah, a choice for someone. And you can choose whatever you want. If you click on one, you can set it directly as your background and lock screen. You can set it directly on your background only, and you set it as your lock screen only. So this is whatever you want. What else can I show you at this moment in GNOME? Let's go to the settings. So we have the Bluetooth, your background, your notifications. So what do you want to be notified on, yes or no? Your search, where do you want to search? How do you want to search? Because if you want to search, let's say I want to search for my files first instead of my contacts, you can drag and drop. Region and language, universal access, if you want to do high contrast or that kind of stuff, fires alerts, official alerts. Your online accounts again. So here you have the complete list of all your online accounts that you can add. Your privacy settings. So very nice. Your applications, you can ask your application how to do, what to do. So it's very good. You can specify more and more things. Sharing, you can enable sharing. Do you want to share your computer name with file sharing, screen sharing, media sharing, or remote logging? So that's very good. Power settings, if you are on a laptop or that kind of stuff, but blank screen, do you want to do black screen or not? Automatic suspend on or off. Your network. So if your wired connect is, you can see it here, but you can also edit, of course, instead of making, let's say if you want a different DNS server, you go to IPv and you don't specify automatic and you specify manually. VPNs, if you have VPNs, your network proxy if you need it, so devices, your screen, your display, your keyboard. They don't have any default other than the default from GNOME, but you can set here all your shortcut keys. So for me, it would be Windows key Shift F for my home folder, my browser, web browser, Windows plus F key, opening a terminal, Windows plus T or Control L T by the default one. So those are things that I would set by default for me in GNOME. Your mouse, left or right button, your mouse speed, natural scrolling or not. Printers, if you have them. What do you want to do with removable media? Thunderbolt settings, if you have it installed. And your color settings. And do you want it automatic or not calibrated? Or this is virtual, so it won't be there. On the right click, display settings we already done. Settings we have gone through. Yeah, this is the basic installation of Fedora. Very nice, minimal, enough to get you started. But if you need extras like multimedia drivers and that kind of stuff, you need to be able to add some repositories. I saw a nice video beginning this week from Chris Titus, where he explains how to install the game engines, so like Lutris and Steam. And also the extra repositories that are will be needed for that. Watch that video, very good. What I wanted to show you, if you don't like GNOME, I'm clicking on my default shortcut keys, but they are not there. So if you don't like GNOME, you can also go to, instead of start, you go to spins.fedoraproject.org And here you can see what kind of spins they have. So by default, they have a KDE Plasma. So you can choose KDE and download it. So it's very nice install. I did a video on Fedora 30 with KDE. So you can watch that one if you want to. I will link it above. An XFCE desktop. They have an LXQT desktop. So also for older system, lighter systems, you can use Fedora. They have the Mate Compass desktop. So Mate is also a very wanted desktop environment by because it looks like GNOME 2 instead of GNOME 3. That's very good. You have the Cinnamon spin-off. So they also throw it to you with a Cinnamon desktop. Very good, very nice. And last but not least, I think, almost last, they have the LXDE desktop, also very good. And a special one, the Soas desktop. If you're interested in that one, check it, because it's completely different than what you're used to. But here are all the spin-offs as well. So, very good. It looks like a very beautiful system. And I hope you enjoyed. Just try it. I hope you enjoyed. Have fun with Linux, guys. And see you next time. Bye.